Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Ever wonder why apples fall to the ground, or why planets orbit stars? One man connected the dots and forever changed our understanding of the universe. Who was he? Isaac Newton. During this unit, you will learn about laws and equations named after Isaac Newton. His lifetime of scientific achievement led to revolutionary ideas that laid the groundwork for modern physics. Let's take a look back into the past and get to know this brilliant scientist. Before we get started, let's look at our goal for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to summarize Isaac Newton's life and his contributions to physics. Isaac Newton was born in 1643 in Woolsthorpe, England. His father died before he was born, and his mother remarried, leaving him to be raised by his grandparents. From an early age, Newton showed an interest in science and mathematics, and he developed a reputation as a gifted student. In 1661, Newton began studying at Trinity College, Cambridge, where he became interested in optics and the work of other scientists, including Galileo Galilei and Johannes Kepler. He graduated in 1665 and returned to his family's estate in Woolsthorpe, where he began his scientific research in earnest. At his family's estate, he stumbled upon groundbreaking discoveries. But guess what? The existing math known at the time wasn't enough to describe his cool ideas. What to do now? He did what any genius would. He invented a whole new type of math. If you end up taking calculus as part of your studies, you'll have Isaac Newton to thank. He invented it in order to describe the phenomenon he observed in his physics work. In 1687, Newton published his most famous work, the Philosophiae Naturalis Principia Mathematica, which described his three laws of motion and his theory of universal gravitation. The book was a monumental achievement and is considered to be one of the most important works in the history of science. After the publication of the Principia, Newton became famous as a renowned scientist and was elected president of the Royal Society in 1703. In the 1700s, the Royal Society of London was considered one of the most prestigious scientific institutions in the world, and held as their motto, Nullius in Verba, which can loosely be translated to, take no one's word for it. This motto emphasized their belief in evidence and experimentation, rather than accepting something just because a respected authority said it. Strangely enough, this was a revolutionary idea at the time. In addition to his scientific work, Newton was also involved in politics and served as a member of Parliament for the University of Cambridge. He wrote extensively on religious topics, including his belief in a universal moral law. In a letter to a colleague, Newton once wrote, "If I have seen further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants," indicating that he recognized the contributions of scientists before him and acknowledged that without their foundations, his discoveries would have been impossible. He continued to work on scientific research until his death in 1727. Now that we've taken a look at Isaac Newton's life, let's see what he did that was so important for physics. If you are familiar with Newton's name before this lesson, it's probably because you have studied Newton's three laws of motion before. We'll take a closer look at each of his three laws later in this unit, but here they are as a quick preview. His first law is known as the law of inertia, and states that objects will not change their motion unless acted on by an outside force. His second law determines that more force is needed for more massive objects and for accelerating to higher speeds. His third law states that for every action force, there is an equal and opposite reaction force. Many of these concepts feel so familiar and so obvious to us now that it may seem surprising that Newton gained such fame and respect for coming up with them. But phenomena that are well understood today were far less so in the 1600s. This was cutting-edge stuff 300 years ago. And without Newton getting these fundamentals set up for us, we would not be where we are now with our knowledge of the universe. Newton also came up with a law of universal gravitation that unifies the actions of gravity on Earth, such as an apple falling from a tree, and the actions of gravity in space that cause planets to orbit stars. With one equation, he was able to predict the force involved in any of these scenarios. He also famously conducted experiments with prisms, determining that white light is made of all the colors of light that can be separated under the right conditions. Chances are, at some point in your life, you've heard the tale. Isaac Newton sitting under an apple tree, pondering the great mysteries of life, and boom! Ouch! An apple falls out of the tree right onto his head. As he winces in pain from his new bruise, an idea suddenly occurs to him. The force that brought the apple to the ground is the same force that causes the planets to orbit the sun, and hence his theory on force and gravity is born. It's possibly the most famous story in all of science, but did it really happen that way? Sadly, we may never know for sure. There is no written record of Newton ever relaying the story in this form, though one of his colleagues included a similar story in a biography that he wrote about Isaac Newton. In this version, Newton saw an apple fall from a tree near his home in Woolsthorpe, which sparked his curiosity about the forces involved, and eventually led to his theory of gravity. So there's a good chance he was never hit on the head with the tasty fruit. That part may have been added later as an embellishment to make the story more memorable. And it seems to have worked, because over 300 years later, we still tell it. As we went through the lesson today, we saw how the contributions of Isaac Newton built a foundation on which physics has grown. Using his discoveries about force and gravity, scientists can now unlock mysteries of the universe that Newton himself would never have imagined. As we go through this unit, we'll use his laws and equations to study force and see how it affects the motion of objects. Next time, we'll start with an overview of the different types of forces, and Newton's name will definitely come up again there. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. See you next time. Hey, hey.